Well, when you think of the Super Bowl coming to Minnesota, chances are you're not thinking of the environment. But the NFL is. When the big game is over, it wants to make sure it's leaving something positive behind in its host city. And as Care 11's Heidi Wigdahl reports, in this case, that something positive is a series of environmental projects.
Put it over. Pull it out first.
At Curry Park, trees are getting prepped before planted.
The root flares are usually pretty deep in here, so you have to look for the first pinky-sized root.
This tree is one of 15 new to the park, a part of the NFL's Super Bowl environmental program, now more than 20 years old.
Can we first of all mitigate the environmental impact? But a second thing is, can we create a green legacy that makes the city somehow better than it was when we got here?
Kids with the Brian Coyle Community Center helped plant the trees, including one gifted from Houston to Minnesota. The Super Bowl 51 host city just finished its final planting project. It's now being handed over to Minnesota, the first of many urban forestry projects leading up to Super Bowl 52.
And we'll be doing as many as a dozen grants around the state to help communities not only plant trees, but also put in some important things like pollinator habitat protection areas as well.
They'll also give unserved food from Super Bowl events to local shelters, use renewable energy to power Super Bowl event venues, and recycle and repurpose leftover decor and construction materials.
Some of our banners and flags and fence material has been turned into shower curtains, beanbag chairs, tote bags, wallets.
But most of those projects will happen during or after the Super Bowl. Planting trees is a step they can take right now.
In the wake of emerald ash borer, which is one of the most destructive forest pests to ever hit the United States, the presence of it here in Minnesota is really prevalent, and this initiative comes at a great time for us to really start replanting trees in our communities.
Yeah, this is very exciting. It's very exciting for the neighborhood and for the city, for Minneapolis in general.
An oasis of green space in one of the city's busiest parks.
I think we're good.
In Minneapolis, Heidi Wigdahl, Care 11 News.